Well, in the previous video lecture, we discussed that if the second order condition is not met and we change the factor x1 and x2 by some amount h1 and h2, then the second order condition will not met. That is, the isoquant will not be convex to the origin at the point of tangency, and the cost will not be minimized. In other words, the profit will not be maximized. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the importance of the second order condition in the decision of maximization or minimization of an economic function. So, as we know that the second order condition helps us to decide whether the function would be maximized or it would be minimized. So let's see how can we decide, how can we use the second order condition to decide about the maximization or minimization of a particular economic function. Suppose we are interested in the cost minimization function in this case, right? And suppose we are using two factor input, that is x1 and x2, right? The price of x1 is w1, the price of x2 is w2. We are missing 2 over here, so this is w2 minus Lagrangian time constraint f of x1 x2 minus w. This is the given level of output. So if we take the first order derivative of the Lagrangian function, we will get this set of equations, the first order derivatives. And if we put it equal to 0 and solve it for wi, we will get this vector. Right, this is the vector of the input prices, and this lambda time the vector of the marginal physical productivity of factor x1 and x2, because you know that the derivative of the production function with respect to the factor input gives you the marginal physical productivity. Now if we take the second order derivative of the Lagrangian function, which in other words means that if we take the first order derivative of the first order condition, this is the same thing, right? So we will get the second order condition, and if we form a matrix of it, we will get this matrix. This is the second order derivative on second order derivative with respect to lambda. This is the on second order derivative with respect to x1. This is the on second order derivative of the Lagrangian function with respect to x2. The rest of the derivative are cross partial derivatives. So it means that in this matrix, the diagonal derivatives are the on second order derivative with respect to lambda, with respect to x1, and with respect to x2. The off diagonal derivatives are the second order cross partial derivatives. And this matrix, the variant, the alternate form of this matrix is given by this matrix. Look at it. This is the second order derivative at the critical values lambda hysteric, x1 hysteric, and x2 hysteric, and it will form this shape, right? Okay. It should be noted that for the minimization of the function, all these, this is the second order derivative, and this is bordered by the first order derivative of the constraint. What is this? F1 and F2, F1 and F2, this is the border, this is the border, this is the border of the first order derivative of the constraint. The border of what? The second order derivative of the function, production function, right? So this, overall, this matrix is known as border Hessian matrix, and if we find its determinant, we will get the border Hessian determinant. For minimization of the function, it should be negative. This is, it contains only one principal minor. The principal minor is bordered by the first order derivative of the constraint. So it means that if you are having more than two factor inputs, then we will have so many leading minors, the first principal minor and the leading minors. So it should be noted that for more factor inputs, all the minors, that is the principal minor and the leading minors, should be negative. But it should be noted that for the maximization of the function, the first principal minor should be positive, the second should be negative, the third should again be positive, and so forth. So for the maximization of the objective function, of the function in which you are interested to be maximized, all the minors should follow alternate signs starting from the positive. The first principal minor should be positive, the second should be negative, and so on. But for the minimization of the function, all the principal minors, or the principal and the leading minors, should be negative. So this is how to make decision using the second order derivative of the function. Thank you. Thanks for watching.